L under root. So they might ask you to derive an expression for frequency of any system which oscillates obeying the simple harmonic motion, executing simple harmonic motion, and they start usually with an equation like this. They give you an equation in this form and they ask you to derive an expression for its frequency or for its time period. Of course, time period is reciprocal to this, so it will become 2 pi L over G under root. So in order to derive this expression, all you have to do is you will compare this part of this equation with the standard equation of simple harmonic motion, which means omega square is G over L, and therefore omega is G over L under root. Therefore, it is 2 pi F, which is equal to G over L under root. And therefore, the expression for frequency or time period can be easily derived from it. So this is one example in which frequency and time period of the oscillating system, which is executing simple harmonic motion, can be derived. We can discuss at least one more system before we finish today's lesson. Another system which executes simple harmonic motion and for which we can derive a similar expression, it is a mass attached to a spring and oscillating on a horizontal frictionless surface. This mass is placed on a frictionless surface and it is displaced by applying a force to this direction. Let's say this is where it finally appears to be when I displace it, and therefore this is the value of X. So when I stretch it by moving it to this direction, I move it through this displacement X, and there is a certain restoring force now which brings it back to the mean position, and in bringing it back it continues to this extreme, and there are oscillations going on for a few seconds at least. So when it continues in this manner, and this is the simple harmonic motion again. Why it is simple harmonic motion again? Because once again we see that the restoring force which brings it back to this is now given by Kx. And this is from the Hooke's law. So this is the force which once again is equal and opposite to our applied force. If I apply a force which is ma, because acceleration is changing at every position, so ultimately at position x, the acceleration that now results when it comes back is equal to the restoring force that develops in it when I move it to this extreme. So my applied force is equal in magnitude to that restoring force at this particular position, but it is in opposite direction. So once again, acceleration can be seen equal to minus k over m into x. This is the term that is of interest for us, because when I compare it with a standard equation for simple harmonic motion is A equals minus omega square x. And these two things are to be compared now, because all other things correspond and they are similar. So if they give you an equation in this form, and you don't have to worry about what happens before it, because usually they do not ask such things. They give you an equation in this form and ask you, why do you think this is a simple harmonic motion? All you have to do is you will write this equation, which is the standard equation for simple harmonic motion, and you can compare. By comparing these two, we can infer that omega square is equal to k over m. K, of course, is the spring constant, because as I said, this is from the Hooke's law. So spring constant multiplied by the displacement in the spring, you can find what restoring force is at work here. So this restoring force has k in it, because that is, of course, something that depends on the spring constant. If spring constant is large, if it's really hard to stretch that spring, it will be larger restoring force produced in it. So ultimately, your frequency depends on the spring constant involved here. And another thing on which it clearly depends is the mass you have attached here. And mass was not appearing in the expression for simple pendulum. That means for simple pendulum, omega does not depend on the mass of the simple pendulum. It only depends on the length of the pendulum. But here it depends on two things. One, it depends on the spring constant involved, and the other is the mass you have attached to it, which is this mass. So omega is obviously k over m under root, and therefore a similar expression can be derived. Frequency is 1 over 2 pi k over m under root, and therefore the period of this oscillation is 2 pi m over k under root. So these are the expressions that you might be required to derive in the exam. We have questions like this in the exam. And today I'm not giving you any worksheet, but you can practice this and you can see a question or two which start from an expression similar to this, and in which you have to derive an expression for frequency and time period. We'll discuss it in slightly more detail and see what other quantities we can infer from this discussion in the next lecture on Wednesday. Thank you.